Hello, welcome to Namlag IT Solution, Odisha, Bhuvneshwar. This is Basir here. Today I have a one case of MBX223 first generation motherboard, a PCH versions. Before going to be start, I have received one gift from Error Solutions, Rishabh Rastogi sir. This is the mat he gifted me. Thank you, Rishabh Rastogi sir, if you watch my videos. And today I have another one things purchased from my Lakib sir. This is the Metro Q multimeter, very cheap price and best results. So this case will be today will handled by our lovable brothers Samir. Samir is belongs to our Brahmapur. Hello. This is Samir, and opposite corner is Ganesh. Is working in our lab. Hi, Ganesh. So you all see my Gurudev Rafi sir will be belong seated with me in the photographs with Kevin Matthew and me. So don't to be delay. We will going to be. So guys, going to be start the case. This is the MBX223 motherboards. It have the problems. Previously the customer told me it will power on and off. It takes some ampere and again once again it will off. You can see it works R&D badly. Everywhere he is doing R&D, but today this case will be handled by our Samir. Samir will show you how to step by step we have to be check this boards and these types of situations. I am going to show you the actually what are the fault in this situations. Then Samir will be guide you how to step by step he will be take the necessary actions to resolve these things. So Samir, please connect the DC connectors. Yeah, this one is the Sony, here is the yes. See here, I'm just giving the power. See, it take 0.010 milliamps, means it show it indicated me perhaps it may be the standby is okay or may be the standby is not okay. Till I have to be wait, because this is the Sony architecture. Sony architecture have the deep sleep well activations, deep sleep well technology. If it have the deep sleep well is okay, yes, it is the deep sleep well is okay, means now it becomes 00004, means my standby is okay and my EC communications will be okay. This is the tricks of identifications of the DC supply of Sony, HP and Dell, many more models which have the inbuilt of DSW, deep sleep well stage. So this is the version of advance of a PCS. This is the first generation, but it is the you can see deep sleep well is active. You can see this is now 0.005 milliamps. Before it takes 0.0010 milliamps. It indicated me my standby is okay. So Samir will going to be show you is that the standby is okay or not. In this condition, standby will not generate because it going to be sleep conditions. Now I have to be once again off, powered off, and then power on, and we going to be check the standby sections is okay or not. Before going to be standby sections, we have to be show you what is the actual problem are giving customers. So Samir, please show me to give the trigger, negative triggers, give the negative triggers. Today I'm going to another one things to show you the best solution of the switch. This technology developed by our beloved Samir. Just connect the one desktop switch like these types, and it is the better solutions for testing motherboards of laptops. You just connect with the terminals to the switch point, and so this is the good technology. You can connect the if you have no switch panel, then you have to be connect with these types of technology. It is the best things. This idea is giving by today Samir. I am not using this idea last 3 to 4 years. Today Samir will give me these things, use the SR these things and test and give me. It is the very best things. This knowledge will not in coming in my mind, but today another one good creativity things will giving by the Samir. Thank you. Now I'm going to be show you what are the actually problems customer giving me. You can see it take 0.010 milliamps, but when giving the power switch, you can see when I'm triggering the power switch, it takes 16 and 1 second back. And mark the board, it show the red light. You can see it show me the red light. It show me the red light. You can see it show me the red light. Okay, so this board have the green switch, green light, red light, and all the other things also have, but it indicated me red light. And when I giving the power, it take 0.18, 0.15, 0.60, and sometime it takes 30, 60, and 1 second back. So Samir will go to show me of the condition of standby, whether the standby is okay or not. You can see the multimeter standby is fine. Okay, 3.3 volt. And show me the 5 volt, whether the 5 volt is okay or not. It's going to be dislip, 1 second to be powered on. Yes. You can see it's 5, exactly 5 volt is coming. So next step, we have to be confirm whether this standby is perfectly working fine or not, or standby is okay or not. So confirmation will come from DSO. So Samir will be use the DSO and show me how to use the DSO by confirmations. Once again, I have to be powered on these things. You can see. Now I'm going to be give the DC, and you have Samir will show me. You can see three lines, it show me straight lines. So this is the output. Show me input. Yes, input also fine. Show me 5 volt sections. So you all can see 5 volt also fine. Okay, so me input or input also fine. So standby is okay, and my standby is okay, and its ampere also okay. But what happens here? It goes. It seems look like maybe DC to DC not jump. Maybe my some voltage will not generate. So in these situations, what will the first step to check? Samir will show you what may be the steps we have to be checked. So we have to be follow to the Samir's. Samir, what do you have to be check next steps?
Sir, first 19 volt check here. Yeah. It's okay.
Okay. So you may can check the when we putting the power switch, when we put the power switch, is there SLP S3, SLP S4 it is released or not. We have to be check and confirm that things.
SL3 S4 is not released, sir.
Not released?
No,
you have confirmed?
Yes.
So once again show me, is it released or not? Once again show me, you have to be open the schematics and check whether the SLP S3 is released or not. You have to be show me. So open the schematics and see where is the SLP S3 and SLP S4 is going. So you have all see, here is the IO communication, IO combinations, SLP S3, SLP S3 is pin number 64. So we SLP S4 is pin number 64. So we have to be sorry, SLP S3 and I, yes, it is the SLP S3. So need to be check any of the sleep well, any of the sleep well, we have to be check it whether the is SLP S3 is present or not. So Samir will show me in pin number 64 whether SLP S3 is coming or not after switching power on the last pin. Now, so now I'm giving the trigger. I'm taking the camera to long time, long way. You can see, mark the multimeter, it comes and go back. You can see red multimeters. I am giving the trigger. You can see I'm giving trigger Yes, it comes and go back. See here, once again I'm giving trigger. See the DC, it take 13 and multimeter show me. So SLP S3 is coming and once again back. So in these situations, what are my proper steps? In these situations, what are my proper step or what are my, this is guys, one thing you have to be remember, this is Sony architecture motherboard which have many more protection circuits. So guys, you have to be remember what are the exact steps to rectify these types of solutions, these types of problems. To rectify these types of problems in Sony architectures, what we have to be checked in proper step, because this is the demo situations, I am not going to be check you to as usual proper steps. I am interesting things for this I make the case study. When I remove these things, when I remove from memory regulator, I am removing the sus on board, sus underscore on the registers, board will constant. So here my doubt going to be suspect to the secondary sections. Now I am going to be remove these registers and so what are the results, is this my board is constant or not. Okay, so remove the registers of PR146. Now please remove the register PR146. I am going to be show you only one thing. You can just see because this board is powered on and go back. So when I remove these things, my board is constant. My board become constant powered. Okay, my board, when I am giving the switching, my board become constant powered on. So remove that register please. So remove that register please. Okay, so I am removing that sus underscore on from RAM regulator sections. Now you can see I am giving the power on. You can see now I am giving the power on. It take 20 and it stay. And it stay there. And my all sleep voltage is constant. You can see my sus on voltage is now constant. My sus underscore on means sus voltage is constant. So why I am showing to you these things, because you may think there be short circuit in other sections, and guys I am told you already customer replaced the RAM IC, and I am also re-verify that RAM IC is not faulty. But this is the clue point I am giving you, after removing the sus on register, why my board is constant. Now I am going to be think your, I want to catch your mind logically, what you all the guys thinking in practical sessions. Theory will told you something other else. If sus on is faulty, now you all see sus on is constant. Previously I am showing sus on will not constant at the time of switching, but I am showing you sus on is constant after removing that registers. But mind it, that IC is not faulty or not output is faulty. So think about the testing point what I am missing. This is the big clue I am giving you. If you are doing practical, you can catch this. If you are not doing practical, you are only reading the theory, you cannot do these things, these types of things. The people who took the marker pen and give the knowledge in blackboard, they will never solve these types of problems. The people, the engineers who will take the blowers and see the schematics and match the whole the circuits with practically, that types of people only can catch my this clue only. The people are typically theory based, cannot catch this fault. The people typically practical based also cannot catch my this fault. The person, the engineer who will mix with schematics and practical, that the engineers or that particular guys will catch my this clue and give me answers. But you guys will decide which things are be the proper steps and proper will be, we can find out the problems. You can see SLP S3 is coming. Okay, once I have to be giving you one another confirmation, if SLP S3 is entered to the IO, then it will release SUSP or any other suspend voltage. So check in the IO. Check in IO. whether suspi or suspi hatch will be released or not. You have to be see. So search in suspi, SUSP.
SUSON.
Oh, so SUSON is there. SUSON. SUSON. Okay. So guys, when SLP S3 is entering into the IO, it will release the another one sleep signals that is called sus on, sus underscore on. So I have to be check that sus on is released or not. So I have to be check, this is the 114, pin number 114. So I need to be confirmation these things, whether my IO is okay or not, whether my everything is working or not properly. So this is the pin number 114. Samir will print out the 114. So I am giving the power. You can see Sasan will come and go. My load site have the sorting, or maybe my previous step have the wrong testings, or maybe I am missing something else to handle this type of situations. Guys, previously I am checking this board. One thing I have told to you, this board have no sorting in secondary situations, like no sorting in RAM sections, no sorting in PCS sections, no sorting in core sections, no sorting in audio sections, no sorting any DC to DC sections. So what are the steps to identify these types of problems? My question is that what the steps Samir is missing, or by missing what the steps we have not checked by the help of DSO or by the help of multimeter to rectify particular this type of problem when board will power on and go back. What are the necessary and mandatory things to have to be checked, or which procedure we have to be checked, or which procedure we have to be handle these types of problems? So let's guy come on and join my the case study, debate case study will held it this Sunday 3 p.m. So guys, you all can join and take a participate in the debate class and know the what are the proper steps, what we have missing, or what sequence we miss, or what are the testing point we have missed, or which are the tricks we have missed to identify these types of fault. Guys, this is the Sony boards. You remind these things. Many more the protection circuits of bin sections. You have to be, I am giving you clues. So take a debate class, take a positions in debate class and debate with me. And to participate this debate, you have to be pay 100 rupees, Paytm at the rate 7894737370, and give me the screenshot. I will add you in classroom. If you want full video, then you have to be do Paytm 500 rupees at the rate mobile number 7894737370 SK Basir. Thank you. Hope all guys will enjoy this case study, coming case study in Sunday, this Sunday. Thank you. Bye bye. So be prepared. This is MBX 223 motherboards. Be ready with schematics and exact times.